I'm Adriana.
And I'm Joe.
Today, we start our countdown of our top five family classic films. Now, Joe and I have completely different lists of movies, and neither of us is aware of the other's choices. So let's see if we come up with any of the same movies. So I'm going to bring it to you, Joe. What is your number five?
Well, I got to tell you, this was not an easy task. There are great family movies out there for many, many, many years. And it was easy for me to narrow it down to about 20. But coming up with five was very, very difficult. And then coming up with the fifth and the fourth and the third and first and all that kind of thing made it even more difficult. So let's take a shot at it. My number five greatest family movie of all time is the original Muppet movie from 1979.
Wow, really? That's a good one to start with, Muppets.
Yeah. What's not to like about this movie? It was their first movie they made. Of course, they were hot with their TV series, you know, their half-hour shows. All the favorite characters are in there. I mean, they pulled out everybody for this movie. You know, Kermit, of course, and, you know, on down Fozzie Bear. You know, of course, animals in it. You know, you got the two old guys, Waldorf and Slater. Stadler, and every other character is in this movie, and the story is just absolutely wonderful. It's nothing more than the group getting together and wanting to go to Hollywood to make it big. come on, it doesn't get any better than that.
Well,
for
that's
family.
The Muppets' main goal all the time.
Yeah.
They always want to make it big. Yeah. I actually have not seen this movie. I have not seen the original, I'm gonna have to watch it. Tell me about it.
Yeah, you're gonna have to watch it. So it starts out, you know, where they start getting the idea together and they start the road trip.
Okay.
And what's neat about this movie is you see things you haven't seen before. Sure, we saw the usual stuff on their TV show and everything like that. But there's one scene where Kermit's actually riding a bicycle. Okay, you see the full Kermit, the frog, you know, you don't see him from the waist down like you always do.
Mm-hmm.
He's actually riding a bicycle. And as they go through this adventure, they're in all kinds of different vehicles as they go, which is kind of cool. So you see the Muppets being portrayed much differently than they were on, you know, the show. But all the usual elements are there. The wisecracks are there. The funny jokes are there. The things, people getting hurt and blowing up and so on, all that. All that stuff is in this. And then what makes this extra special is they pulled everybody off the movie lot to help make this movie.
Okay.
And I'm just going to run down the list really quick here. Charles Darning is in, Edgar Burton, Milton Berle. Mel Brooks is in it, James Caan's in it, Dom DeLuise, Elliot Gould, Bob Hope, Madeline Kahn, Cloris Leachman, Steve Martin, Richard Pryor, Telly Savalas is even in this thing, and so is Orson Welles.
Wow.
You know, I mean, oh my God. I mean, these are all top stars.
I don't know how I've missed this one.
Yeah, so, and everybody is in this thing. And again, it's just good, clean family adventure.
Fun.
It's a G-rated movie. This is the movie that basically hatched a franchise of, I think, seven movies, including the Muppet movie that just came out here a couple years ago, which was very good also. So they did very well with this, made a ton of money on the first movie and the movies that followed it. Highly recommended. If you haven't seen it, get the kids together. It's just good old-fashioned G-rated slap happy fun and games with the Muppets.
So tell me, what was your favorite skit in this movie? Because they usually do a lot of little skits. So what was your favorite this one?
You know what? I got a very soft spot for two places, and that's any scene that Animal is in. Okay, because he's just out of control, and it's always back in the drums, you know, that kind of thing. So, you know, how can you love or not love any scene with him in it? And but my favorite scenes are any time the two old wisecracking guys come up, you know, and they're in this movie off and on as it goes on, just making the usual wisecracks like, oh, there's no way this is going to work, you know, and that kind of thing. So that's pretty good. And then finally, the scene where they meet the big movie producer who ends up giving them their big break, and that would be Orson Welles.
Oh, so Orson Welles was the movie producer.
Yeah.
That's
a great scene, too. Just a little side note, as a uncredited voice in this production is a young Tim Burton.
Really?
Yeah, so he had a part in this, along with a lot of other big-name animators and that kind of thing that are uncredited, as they used to do back then. So.
Well, the Muppets have been a huge franchise forever. I mean, you know, it always gets the kids involved. Who doesn't love puppets? So was Miss Piggy still chasing Kermit?
Actually, they fall in love.
Oh, so this is where they fall in love.
Sorry, spoiler alert on that one. But yeah, they actually get together and fall in love, if you will. So, and it's a very tender scene with singing and that type of thing. Because you got to remember, this is a musical. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, they do a lot of singing, and it's like they do all their shows. So that's there too. And that's so. All right, so I'm just dying to hear your number five, so go ahead and hit me.
Okay, so like you, I had a very tough time deciding what five movies were my favorite out of this category. But I'm going to start with something that I completely love. I love watching this movie. I actually watched it the other day again. My daughter loves this movie as well. So it's actually The Goonies, 1985.
Oh, excellent choice.
This movie, you know, was directed by Richard Donner, and it was co-written by Steven Spielberg and Chris Columbus, as
I knew that.
You know, I love this movie because it's just, you've got these group of kids. They're in a situation where they don't want to leave their home. And how many times, you know, when we were children and we had to move from one space to another, from one, you know, suburb to the next or city to the next. And it's very hard. You don't want to let go. You've got your group of friends and you just want to stay where you are because you're comfortable.
Right.
So, you know, here they are. They're comfortable. They want to stay where they are. And they hatch a plan to try to discover some buried treasure, some buried pirate treasure, which ensues some great fun as they are unwittingly thrown in with a bunch of criminals, the Fratelli brothers. So that is kind of the premise of the movie, and just so many fun little things that happen. You know, you've got these great kid actors that grow up to then, you know, become major actors. So this was one of the first times we saw Sean Astin, who later went on to obviously go into Lord of the Rings and do a couple other great movies. You get to see them as children, and you see that they did become major actors and major players in Hollywood later. You've got some very hilarious moments in this movie. You've got some slapstick. You've got some little witty conversations going back and forth. One of my favorite scenes in this movie, it's hilarious for me because I understand Spanish. So when Mouth is translating for the maid that they hire to help pack, and he is just really scaring her. He's using this opportunity to scare her by telling her that, you know, everything that the mom is telling him to translate, which is, you know, oh, I just need you to pack these things away. These things are going to go in this box and this thing is going to go in this box. And he translated it as into, there's drugs that you need to pack. And if you don't do it, you're going to get punished and you're never going to get water and we're going to keep you in the cellar. So it's just so hilarious. You know, and then you've got the end scenes, they find the treasure, and it's just these magical moments that, you know, most kids love that sense of adventure and wonder, and you get to see it live on screen, and it's just a wonderful movie.
It is a fave also. They did an excellent job of capturing that age group and the sense of adventure and the passion and the innocence and that type of thing. And it's genuine. You know, when you watch it, you can't help but to get sucked in to this. But, you know, to your earlier point, I think what's special about this movie is you do see actors when they're younger and obviously have made it now in Hollywood in a much bigger fashion. But you can see the talent even back then. You know, if you watch it and you say, you know what, there's something already there. And to watch that blossom into a major role like Lord of the Rings and so on and so forth, I think that makes it even more special.
This movie took only 5 months to make. I mean, and you see the production value in it, and you see that this movie has endured the test of time. I mean, kids today watch it and they still can connect with it. Yep. They still, you know, get that sense of amazement. And to have done that in 5 months is astounding, you know?
Yeah, especially these days.
Most movies take so long.
All right. Well, you picked a good one. That's, you know, that's would definitely be in my top 20 list, no doubt about it. So
yeah, I think you picked a good movie too. I mean, here we are. We're going to be counting down our top fives. Each of us have a different list, you know, and we are keeping each other in the dark.
Yeah.
So I don't know if we're going to cross paths, but, you know, I think this is going to give our audience a good feel for the types of movies we both generally connect with.
All right. Well, I'm going to thank everybody for having joined us for this latest episode of the Popcorn Diaries, and join us next time when we'll be discussing our next movies in our top five, which would be movie number 4. All right, folks, thanks for joining us here for this edition of the Popcorn Diaries.